So let's start the brain gym exercise. But before starting exercise, let me see how your brain is working. So my first question is, what is the half of 18? I want your answers. Half of 18 is 9. Okay, fine. Any else answers? What is half of 18? Any other answers? Okay, one. One of the best answer. Half of 18 is 1. Any other answers? Any other answers? Half of 18 is 1, half of 18 is 8, half of 18 is 9. Very good. Anything else? Half of 18 is 8, that's correct. Anything else? 8. 8, okay. Ah, okay, fine. Half of the 18 is 8. Right? You're cutting it. So this is EIGH and this is teen. So that is also correct. 18, yes, right. And what else? Half of 18 is 10. Half of 18 is 10 because if I cut from the middle, so there's a 10 figure. So there are a lot of other things. There are a lot of things which actually we need to scratch our brain. So most of the times our brain actually works in a one way, because we just make our brain work in a particular manner. By doing this gym exercise, I'm very sure that your brain will, you know, think in a different way, in a different way. Because here we are training our left brain and right brain at the same time. So I'll be doing very simpler exercises, and this will hardly take 2 to 3 minutes at your home. So whenever you're free, just try to practice this exercise, because this will make a lot of difference in your life. So first, let me just show you. I want you to repeat the same things. Even by sitting, it's fine. So the first is, you'll be holding this finger and you are going to move your thumb first in a clockwise direction. Once you move clockwise direction, you complete, and then you try to move anti-clockwise direction. Clockwise, your left brain will move, left brain will function, and anti-clockwise, your right brain will function. The same thing goes for the forefinger. Clockwise, just try to move it clockwise, and then anti-clockwise. And then your middle finger, clockwise, and then anti-clockwise. Clockwise, and then anti-clockwise. Then your fourth finger, ring finger, clockwise. It is little bit difficult, but practice will give you perfect. And anti-clockwise. Clockwise, your little finger, clockwise, pinky finger, and anti-clockwise. Now do the same thing by reverse. First anti-clockwise, your pinky finger, and then clockwise. Because it is going to stress your brain, left part and right part of your brain, and then it is going to give you best results in future. It's an exercise. So now coming back to your forefinger, clockwise, and then anti-clockwise. First you can do anti-clockwise and then clockwise, that's okay. First anti-clockwise and then clockwise. So this first exercise, let's move for the second exercise. Second exercise little bit is difficult. So now first two fingers I'm opening, which is my forefinger and middle finger. So when I open my forefinger and middle finger, here I'll be opening the other two fingers, which are ring finger and middle finger. So these two are not same. I'm not opening these two fingers actually. I'm opening these two fingers, which are middle finger as well as ring finger. Where am I opening the other two fingers? So if I keep this number 2 and number 3, it is number 3 and number 4. So this is 2, 3 and this is 3, 4. So this is how it is. And when I open this two, it is reverse. There is coordination actually in brain. I can open these two fingers very easily. But it is difficult for our brain to choose this option. So 2 and 3, 3 and 4. And the vice versa, reverse. 2, 3 and 3, 4. So make it fast. So here when I don't do this one, because here 2, 3, is wrong. So when I use 2, 3, so I'll be using 3, 4. It is little bit difficult, so it will lead sudden practice. Yes. Yeah, you can do it. So you need to change your finger. You need to change your finger. Yes, that's a little trick which is there. So it will, you will do it by practice. Yeah. Yes, you need to think. within fraction of seconds, your brain from left part it is going to right part, and from right part it is coming to left back. So you're just having control of your mind, your brain, left and right brain. Yes, coordination. Yes. So you need to be, you can do it very fast, provided if you train it. And the next is, this is my, I like this exercise, my favorite exercise. So first your right hand, and just try to just do this. Yeah, just pat onto your head. Now, just remove it. Now, with left hand, just with left hand. Yeah. Now you have to do both the things, but as I said, both the things should do simultaneously. Sometimes what happens, you do both the things simultaneously, but that is wrong. Yes. 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 No. But that is yes. 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 You do this correct. So that's wrong. So just do first action by right hand and then the same action, the other action by left hand. Just do it 5 times and then change it. Now it is reverse. Yes. Now you use left hand just for this one, for action 1, and for action 2 it is right hand. Now again change it. So we are going to just train our mind so efficiently that it will do 2 tasks simultaneously, where your left brain and right brain is functioning. Yes, yes. And the vice versa. Yeah, that's it. So the last one more, because the other dancers are there, so I don't think it is suitable. So just do this, just open your 5 fingers, right. Yeah, your right hand. So this is a gun actually, so you're going to just shoot it 1, 2, and then this 5 fingers will open, and then this will become a pistol gun, and then you're going to just shoot just 2 times, and then 5 fingers again. Now this time three fingers are going to shoot, and then again here 5 fingers, and then 3 fingers are going to shoot. So your left and right brain should be very quick enough. 5 fingers and then 4 fingers will shoot, and then again 5 fingers and 4 fingers will shoot. This is difficult. So 4 fingers will shoot. Now the 5 fingers and 5 fingers will shoot. 5 fingers and 5 fingers. Now 5 and 4. Four will shoot. Now 5 and 4. Yeah. Now reduce. Now 3 fingers will shoot. Now 3 fingers will shoot. Now 2 fingers. So that's how we can train our mind. Yes. Obviously, it is a big exercise for mind. For freshers, it will be little difficult.
Good for the left and
the left. Yes, yes. So the level which I showed you, very basic level, is number first level. There are second level, there are third level, where you will be drawing a circle as well as you are making a square also. So you are doing 2 activities which are actually not opposite. Yeah. The reason we are not able to write with our left hand, right hand is the same thing, because we have trained one part of our brain very strong. We are become just logical, or some people they are become very creative, because they have tried to use only one mind. If we are able to use our two minds, then we can become actually the real genius. So that's what about the brain gym exercise, and thank you so much. I think you practice it. Thank you very much, sir.